Hi, sister. Oh, look at you. Oh, by the way, I'm Jan Burkins. And she's Kari Yates. And we're the authors of Shifting the Balance, 6 ways to bring the science of reading into the balanced literacy classroom. And Kari
Love
is.
dark chocolate. Let's just say that. I love dark chocolate.
She's eating some dark chocolate.
And I thought I'd eat a little more right before we came on, Jan, because I read this thing today that described like a lot of benefits of dark chocolate.
Really?
Yeah, like
What
for
are the
instance,
benefits? I need to hear this.
improves brain function.
Oh, good. I could use that one.
Raises good cholesterol while lowering bad. Reduces
Wow.
heart disease risk,
Wow.
boosts your vision, protects your skin. Listen to this, boosts your mood. You should encourage me to eat more of it. It says it aids your oral health. Seems contradictory, but
Oh, take care of your teeth by eating more chocolate. That
I
does seem
guess it's got
counterintuitive.
some kind of healthy thing in there that, according to this. So, I mean, it's full of antioxidants. It's got all sorts of benefits. So,
Well, sister, I'm kind of curious about who's doing that research. And is it possible? I mean, just bear with me. Is it possible that your bias towards eating chocolate is leading you to really lean into this research? Maybe there's a little confirmation bias going on there with this dark chocolate research.
I mean, it's possible.
Unlikely,
I'm
I'm
happy
sure.
to read it because I'm committed to eating dark chocolate either way. And so, yes, I probably am prone to confirmation bias, which is that tendency to kind of look for what we hope to find.
Would you be as eager to share with me research you found that said dark chocolate was not as good for you?
I haven't seen any of that, so no, I didn't come prepared. I mean, yeah. Okay. So there's that.
Well, there is that. And
And there probably is research out there telling lots. I mean, I remember when you were thinking about coffee
oh yeah.
and all
Cheers
of
to
the
that.
pros and
All
cons of
right.
coffee.
Right. There are some pros and cons. And I think the research on the pros is probably a lot better research than the research on the cons. But
Especially, yeah.
all that to say that when we're thinking about research, we have to look out for the biases that we bring.
Yeah.
And we have to read into the thing that maybe makes us question our beliefs and makes us a little bit uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And really, the decision about whether to drink coffee or to eat chocolate, how that research actually translates into practice, since it's so oftentimes inconsistent or contradictory.
Yeah.
It's not always a clear decision. And
Yeah, it's not a
so,
clear yes or no for coffee or dark chocolate. And the same is kind of true, I think, with the research about how the brain learns to read and translating that into practice as well.
Absolutely.
The research might be clear, but the translation to practice might not be as clear. And so that is, I think, one of the things that was on our minds when we put together that.
Teacher-friendly guide
That
to
teacher-friendly
reading
guide
research.
for the yeah.
Oh, something like that. Teacher-friendly guide
Teacher-friendly
to
guide to
making
making
sense
sense.
of
Yeah.
scientific research.
Yeah. So do you want to
And
tell everybody where they can find that one?
sure, it will link it down in the description, but it's just a document to help you think about how to approach a large body of information and kind of come away with some sense of how it might apply. And so you can find it on our site, thesixshifts.com, and we'll put a link down in the description. And in the meantime, there seems to be enough in favor of dark chocolate and coffee. So cheers to you.
And that guide is on the
Enjoy.
downloads page of our website. I think it's
Absolutely.
one of the first or second things you'll find there. So here's to sorting through the research and, wouldn't help to gnaw on a little chocolate as you do it.
Yeah. Take care, friends. Bye.